If you live here in Swansea, I am your neighbor. If you live here in Denver, I am your neighbor. In May of 2013, Chicago Mayor Rahm Emanuel announced plans to close 50 public schools, more schools than had ever been closed in a single district. Nearly all of the schools were in African American and Latino neighborhoods. That same month, a third grade boy named Ashawn Johnson, who attended Marcus Garvey Elementary School, one of the schools on the list to be closed, climbed onto a wobbly folding chair in front of a crowd at Chicago's Daily Square and declared a fight with the mayor of Chicago. Addressing the mayor, he said, "You should be investing in these schools, not closing them. You should be supporting these schools, not closing them. This is racism right here." He went on to lead the crowd in a chant declaring that education is a right, and this is why we have to fight. On May 22nd, it was announced that Marcus Garvey Elementary School would remain open. Ashawn fought, and Ashawn won, but he did not win alone. He won with the teachers' union and entire community alongside him. They are still fighting, and in fighting, they are still winning. In the years since 9/11, there has been an increased targeting of immigrants in this country, most of which are people of color. Millions have been branded illegal, have been deported, have been systematically denied full access to live in a country that they helped build, in a country they enrich, in a country that would not be this country without them. In 2010, four immigrant college students in Florida, Juan Rodriguez, Felipe Matos, Gabby Pacheco, and Carlos Rosa, all in their early 20s, decided that they would walk 1,500 miles to the White House to declare a fight with Barack Obama and the federal government. Along their walk, they confronted the KKK and a racist sheriff who they dared to arrest them. In town after town, they were joined by fellow undocumented immigrants who marched at their side wearing t-shirts that said undocumented and unafraid. When they got to the White House, now accompanied by a group of supporters, they demanded that Barack Obama stop deportations and pass the DREAM Act. In early June of 2012, undocumented activists, dreamers, occupied President Obama's campaign offices across the country and demanded that he stop deportations and pass the DREAM Act. On June 15th of 2012, President Obama announced that authorities would no longer deport DREAM Act eligible undocumented youth. In November 2014, with Congress having failed to enact immigration reform, President Obama announced that he would circumvent Congress and use executive action to protect nearly half of the estimated 11 million undocumented immigrants from deportation and offer temporary legal status. The Dreamers fought, and the Dreamers won. The Dreamers are still fighting, and in fighting, they are still winning. To fight is to win. The teachers' union fighting for education justice in Chicago, the Dreamers fighting for immigrant justice across the United States, Black Lives Matter fighting for racial justice across the United States, the occupiers fighting for economic justice across the United States have shifted the consciousness and courage of the entire nation. They have built bridges and tied communities together. They have sown seeds of strength and love where there were none. They did that in the fight, not in the win, which is why to fight is to win. City officials would have us believe that the decision to rip a hole in our neighborhood has been made final. That the decision to cut a gaping wound further separating us from the rest of Denver and from our friends and family members on the other side has been made final. That the decision to release toxic dust into our lungs and the lungs of our children is final. That the decision to forcefully take the homes of members of this community who have lived here their entire lives is final. This is racism right here. This is colonialism right here. And they say that it is final. Final. Maybe. Maybe as final as Mayor Rahm Emanuel's decision to close Ashawn's school in Chicago. Maybe as final as the U.S.'s decision to deport all undocumented immigrants. Because until we see an underground 21-lane highway over there, nothing is final. My name is Brent Adams, and I am a founding member of the Cross Community Coalition, the Registered Neighborhood Association in Swansea, reestablished by Candice de Vaca. I'm your neighbor, I would like to be your friend, and I'm willing to be your comrade. Last week, with the help of the Sierra Club and other community groups, we began the process of suing the Colorado Department of Transportation. We are declaring a fight. We are not starting a fight, we are deciding to fight back. And because we are going to fight, we are going to win. If nothing else, fighting will bring this community closer together. We'll create new bonds of friendship. We'll show our children that this is a good neighborhood, that their lives and memories cannot be easily swept away by people who don't live here and who don't know us. If nothing else, we will declare that this is a neighborhood worth fighting for. If you are willing to join us, even if you live in another neighborhood, you can give Candy or I your information, and we will send out information about the fight and what is happening, and what you can do to fight also. This is our fight. I am just a tiny drop of water, and we are all just tiny drops of water. But I look out across my neighborhood and my city, and I see an ocean. And an ocean cannot be moved. An ocean cannot be cut. And an ocean cannot be washed away. Thank you.